Welcome back to the program. Some have said he's one of those spearheading the current trend in the PDP. He has spoken perhaps louder than the party itself since its party came into the opposition role. Governor Yodele Fayoshe of Ekiti State joins us now on the program to discuss the party issues and state of the nation. Thank you so much, Governor Fayoshe, for joining us on the program.
Good to see you again.
Thank you so much. Your party is in crisis, you believe so?
I take exception. There's nothing unusual.
In the party right
no,
now?
No, nothing unusual.
When you had a World Congress where almost half of the states where the Congress held, they cancelled it, they postponed it, they factionalized it.
Yeah, well, party politics is about interest. And when you have interest that is diversified, you have to go for the interest. You can't hide it. It is about people struggle for positions. And what is important is, even if we have to take it over and over again, we must get it right. That is what is important.
But is the party getting it right?
Very right. You have to start a journey of 100 years by the first step.
But even with a zoning arrangement where a lot of the leaders, Chief Bodejudge is one of those who do not agree with it. He said, this is no zoning. Do you agree with that?
That's what I'm saying to you. Party politics is about interest. Chief Bodejudge is interested in that position.
In the chairmanship of the
Exactly. So who is aggrieved and who is not aggrieved? The first thing is the motive. I have a lot of respect for Chief Bodejudge. He's our leader. We continue to respect him. But when we come to the nitty-gritties, where is the interest? Who is interested? Why am I crying? Why am I shouting? Why am I complaining? You must find out the underlining factors. Chief Bodejudge told me personally he wants to be national chairman of a party. I told him, no, I won't support him.
Why would you not support him?
I won't support him.
He's been a party.
You see, let me tell you this very quickly, Sheu. With all due respect to the elderly people in this party, they must take the backstage. People are tired of seeing the same old faces again. Sheu, if somebody 15 years, 20 years older than you sitting on this table, people will look away. They've seen their faces enough. Everybody's looking out for you because you're fresh. This change we're talking about is doing things differently in different ways. I've been hearing Ahmadu Ali since 1976 when we sang Ali Must Go in primary secondary school. Chief Bodejudge has been governor of Ondo State almost 40 years ago. They are our leaders, we love them. They should take the backstage. Sheu, at 70, 75, I will still be struggling with my son for political appointment. For positions, no, God forbid, bad thing.
Governor Fayoshe, you are a leader of the party in the Southwest.
Yes.
It's amazing for some members of the party to believe that some of the leaders in the South were rejected the national challenge.
I don't blame them.
Do you support them?
Wait, Sheu, I don't blame them. You see, like I told you, this is about interest. Chief Bodejudge was the convener of that meeting. Most people that came to that meeting did not know what they were coming for. They came, there was already arranged communique which they must read. Fantastic. We are in a very peculiar time where we need to address issues differently. Each time anybody is talking about founding fathers, founding grandmother, founding great grandfather, they got it wrong. That was why we lost the election in 2015. I don't want to hear that song again. Grandfather of PDP. The grandfathers of PDP lost it in 2015. It's a new beginning. They should pocket those stories.
But you think the Southwest does not deserve...
Jim, I've gone beyond the Southwest. I've told you, Chief Bodejudge is an interested party. I've told you that meeting was called without an agenda. You got there, agenda was brought up, and something must be said to the press. I don't want to go into all that. In a meeting where you don't have a sitting governor, we have two sitting governors. We are not there. Sheu, the owner of Channels Television is a key player. Directors, co-directors, they are key players. Sheu, when you see the attendance of a meeting, you can determine if this meeting is well attended. There could be sympathizers of people that are interested. But I don't want to go into all that. Again, Sheu, Nigerians, PDP young people, they don't want to see these old leaders, our leaders, 70, 75, 80, should take the backstage. Let me tell you very quickly, this is not sweet. But I want to tell you, I am an ardent supporter of former President Goodluck Ebele Jonathan. I love him. I will continue to defend his cause. I'll continue to stand up for him because he did well. Keep the story. The others might tell me this story, that story. That's another day. In my opinion, perfect. Now, let me tell you, the only thing Jonathan did, I keep saying it, and I hardly want to say it, is that if I were him, I wouldn't have contested.
For the president?
Correct.
Why?
Because the people that went to tell Jonathan, that convinced him to run, making him to understand at 58, when you will be done, how would a young man be 58 and say, I've finished, done with presidency. They were the first set of people who said, we have retired from politics. They didn't even allow him to get home before they said that. All leaders coming out today to say they want to rebuild. Rebuild what? What you destroyed? You don't have capacity to do it.
But they don't have capacity to do it.
They should allow young people, Sheung, they should allow young people to take the center.
So is that the reason why the Southwest must trade its opportunity of being a national chairman?
Let me tell you. Let them tell me how many people has come out in PDP that they want to contest in Southwest. I was the first person that went to Dr. Bode Olajumoke and told him, Oga, if this thing comes to Southwest, I want you to come out. He was at the meeting, Chibode just told me quite clear that he would want to run. And from there, I said, no, it's not going to work. You must have, before you zone, you must zone to individuals. You don't just zone.
You have experienced politicians like Dr. Doyin Okupe, a lot of them in the Southwest.
Dr. called me too. I told him we were not going to support him.
He wants to run too?
Yes. So when they come to the television and they are talking, they are interested parties. Say, well, let me tell you this very expressly. Even if I were Chief Doyin Okupe, I love him. I respect him. He's our leader. But let me tell you one fact. You are the spokesman of the immediate past president. Enough to say that you lost with that president. What have you to say again to Nigerians? What is new that you want to come and tell Nigerians? What you want to rebrand, or you want to recreate, or you want to tell us a miracle will happen?
You might have a better way of doing things this time.
Well, I am somebody who doesn't polish words, so I tell you if you like, take. If you don't like, go and throw it in the lagoon.
But Governor Fayose,
yes,
does the zoning that the neck? The next meeting, which
I was
the first
the deputy
place.
Chairman of the zoning committee, if I may tell you that.
So this in your in
that is the, you see, minority majority will have their way, minority will have their say. Sheung, party politics is about people. 70 people attended the zoning committee. 70 voted for the North as chairman.
What's the reason? The major reason?
I don't know. Sheung, politics is about number. You can give reasons for talking on this in the television. I can't give reasons why people voted against me. It's their decision.
But there must be a reason why they unanimously agreed that the national chairman, which a lot of people think, the Southwest has never had it in 16 years.
It is. You see, what I'm telling you, we're in peculiar times. All these stories started by the so-called founding fathers has led us to the grave, to the Golgotha. They should keep down to such stories.
Some of the people in the Southwest, she said, you have betrayed them in the Southwest.
I can never betray them.
Because they believe that.
Everybody in Nigeria knows me. I'm a very clear person.
That he is a turn of this region.
I've just asked you a question. I've just said this to you. I was the very first person that said, called Chief, looked out for Senator Bode Olajumoke. I was the first person. I mentioned that he must come to the Southwest. I'm telling you again, how many of them came or publicly said, I want to contest? You don't give position to unwilling horses.
So you are still...
I'm telling you, tell me. Somebody that has come out in Southwest that says he wants to contest. You don't carry party position to go and beg people. Not like those days when you say when somebody wants to be an Oba, you go and take him from the bush where he's farming. Say the lot falls on you to come and be over. People don't carry bush people again, no?
So Senator Alimadu Sharif is your candidate all the way?
By all means, now. By all means.
At this national convention?
He's incumbent and he's still going to win this election.
And is he supporting him to be president?
I stand by him. I take exception to that.
Would you support him to become a president?
I take exception to that.
Would you support him?
How would he come out to say he wants to be president of where? Let me say to you very expressly, don't when I come here, don't ask me questions based on packaging of opposition, telling me if Fayose wants to be deputy of Alimodu Sheriff. If I want to be vice president of Nigeria, I will show interest legitimately. I'm a young man. It's quite deserving. Even people mentioning my name gladdens my heart. But let me tell you, if Alimodu Sheriff attempts to do anything to the contrary, in the runnings of this party, I will come out and run it and talk against him. I'm a very blunt person. Alimodu Sheriff should obey our rules, follow our rules, do everything in line with what is supposed to be done. When you are talking about presidency, how will he go and steal it? You want to be the referee? You want to take goalpost? No, that's not going to work. Let me say to you expressly. I'm a very, very straightforward man. I will not be part of anything. How would he do it? You think other interest stakeholders in Nigeria are fools or what? Mentioning my name to say I want to be vice president, it's a cheap blackmail.
You don't want to be a vice president?
Oh, no, if an opportunity comes, I won't run away.
You could contest in 2019.
You don't contest for the office of a vice president.
You could show interest.
You don't show interest for it. My deputy didn't show me interest. I picked him. Atiku was picked by Obasanjo.
He could lobby it.
No, let me tell you, let me put this right. Let me put it this way. I don't want to talk about this kind of issues. Nigerian people are just giving me an opportunity. I'm not even halfway. So talking about such things is unreasonable. I wouldn't be found in that. So don't let us waste our energy discussing this. I'm supporting Alimodu Sheriff right now, without doubt. You see, there's a difference between blackmail and reality. Somebody said that Alimodu Sheriff is the Boko Haram, whatever. That is coming from the pit of hell by the opposition. Alimodu Sheriff is an in-law of Buhari. Alimodu Sheriff elected 3 times as senator. Alimodu Sheriff elected 2 times as governor. Let me tell you, for anybody who cares to listen to the truth, they are all games of politics. You cannot elect a man 3 times senator, 2 times governor. You are saying the man is Boko Haram. Boko what? This one that we are talking about is, I am supporting Alimodu Sheriff. I will stand by him publicly. I will work for him.